Hello, welcome to your new session. Today we are going to discuss about encryption and decryption. Generally, we are going to use encryption and decryption in Selenium for the username and password. If in your framework, generally what you do, you keep your username password either in a config file, like in a dot property files or XML or JSON or in feature file, or generally you pass your username and password from the testng.xml. But if you push that code into any of the Git repository, what you will get? Basically, you'll get an mail from the admin or from the Git repository or Big Bucket or Stash, whatever it is. Like, some vulnerabilities will be erased because you should not keep username and password into these repositories. So, what is the solution? Solution is generally we keep the username password in the form of encrypted way, and when we use it, we'll decrypt it. So, how the process works, basically encryption, you have to know it first. So, you keep your username password in a plain text that get encrypted using a key, okay, secret key we call it, okay, and then it will get decrypted using the same key and to convert into the plain text using a Java. Basically, we are going to, there no specific jar we are going to use it. We'll create an object of creepers, and with the help of that creepers we'll encrypt and decrypt it, okay. So let's go into the code. So if you see what I'll do it, first we have to encrypt and decrypt. So what I have done it, I have created one config file where I have given my username, password, original password, then encrypted password, and then key. But when you will use it, you will not use the original password. You'll just directly put it into the mather and encrypt it, and then you delete that password. Okay. Only this encrypted password will be kept and keys will be kept, because keys are needed for encryption and decryption. Okay, so what I have done it, first method is like I have reading the property file using this file readers and properties. I'm loading the property file, and then what I'm doing it, I'm getting that properties using this get method, okay, and converting into the string. Okay, so property dot get, that is a method, or get properties or another method also is there. So get property directly will convert into the string, but get will have to convert into the two strings, which we have to use two string with a get. The two methods are there, get property directly. Okay, now I've got this username, that original password, okay, then password, and then key. You can delete your password, you can directly pass your password, original password, directly here, and then decrypt it, and then you can put your decryptions into the config file, and then you can use it. But to show you, I have just given all these details. Okay, so first I'll run it, encryptions and decryptions. Okay, how it is happening? First method is key set. We are creating a key set using UTF-8, and there are some methods are like get instance of SHA-1, and then AES object like key space, and then we are passing the key to do the encryptions and decryptions. Okay, then we have created two methods, encryption methods and decryption method. First we'll encrypt using creepers. We'll okay get instance with which object you are going to create it, and then pass the secret key. Okay, got it, and then the two string encryptions, whatever the encryptions are there, we'll pass it, and it will get encoded into 64 base. Okay, and we'll get the encrypted password. Next, we are using decryptions, where we are decrypting the same password using the same key. Okay, got it, and then we'll print it. So first what we are going to do it, like we are, you can see the method encrypt, I'm passing original password which I have read it from the property file. In your framework you should not keep this one into your property file. Just to show you, I have kept it into the property file. Okay, I can comment it also. If I don't need the original password, I'll just remove it. Let me remove it. Okay, and then into the math here, I'll just put a here, and directly I'll pass it for encryptions. Okay, so this is a password. Okay, and the secret key. Let me run it. You see, this is the encryption. I have got it. Now this encryption, I'll use it for my in the property file, and you can see the same encryption, I have decrypted it, I have got the same password, you can see it. Okay, So in the property file, I'll just go and replace the password with the encryption password. Okay. Now, since my work is done, I'll not use this encryption again, because encryption need to be done only once in your scripts basically. So I'll just do only once and keep it into the config file. Whenever the password is getting changed, again you have to do the encryptions. Otherwise, this will work till you have like configured it. If your passwords are not changing basically, so I'll just decrypt it and then I'll run a method login into an application. So I'm passing username and password, which is a decrypted password. So I'm just passing it. I'm logging into application and then signing and checking whether I'm logged in or not. Okay, so you can see the descriptions will happen with the help of a secret key. So that's the reason I'm reading that secret key. Okay, fine. So let's run it. Very simple, just encryption and decryptions. Now you see I have decrypted it. You should not do it. You should not call that method in your program, because logs will be generated, and sometimes logs get generated into the server where you run it, like either in the Jenkins or TeamCity or any other bamboos and all. So you should not put this decryption passwords like directly. You should not put it. You should use it in the application. So what is doing is just signing in the application with a username and password with a decrypted way. So it will do using decryption. You see, okay, and then our login has been done, and then it will close the browser. So this is how you use encryptions and decryptions in your Selenium framework, in any Selenium framework, whether it is a Cucumber framework, TestNG framework, or anything. You just do encryption and save it into the property file. Okay, so this is how the encryptions and decryptions work. Thank you for watching my video. Please do subscribe.